Hello everyone, this is Fidel. We're starting shortly. Professor Roy will be presenting a webinar on same relevant in today's contemporary society. This webinar is recorded. You are going to get this presentation after the webinar is over. During the duration of the presentation, you will be muted just to make sure there is no noise. You can ask questions in the chat box. Our control room will be monitoring overall. Any issue, any conflict, let us know in the chat box. Thank you. I'm now giving back to Professor Roy, who is introducing himself. He is actually a teacher in a professional MBA school, and he has done lots of research in facility management and brand endorsement. And it has been kind of him to come to our school university as a teacher to present this. He has written some couple of case studies which he featured, of course, with the university as well. You can see it quick.
Hello and welcome everyone to this webinar on personality differentiation. To this webinar on personality differentiation. The topic of this webinar is staying relevant in today's consumerist society. Now, when I mention this word consumerist society, I need to delve a bit deeper into the very topic, that is staying relevant in today's consumerist society. When I mention this word consumerist society, it's not just about the products that are being available in the market, but I am also talking of personalities. I am also talking about human beings with whom we are interacting, either on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis, whatever it is. And over here, when I mention this word consumerist, it is the reason, it is why I am mentioning this word consumerist is because each one of us is looking for value. Each one of us is looking for value for the products that we are purchasing from the market, and also when we are interacting with people, we are looking for value from that particular association. We make friends on Facebook, we make friends on LinkedIn, and again over there we are looking for value. We just don't make friends who will not be of any use to us, who will not be of any value to us. So such is the proportion of consumerism that has reached in our society. Now the next part of this particular topic is staying relevant in today's consumerist society, and that means you have to differentiate yourself in order to be relevant in today's society. And when I say differentiation or differentiate, it is about, as a personality, how you are presenting yourself, how you are managing yourself, what are your mannerisms, the way you are packaging yourself, the way you dress up, the way you meet with people, the way you conduct yourself in the society. Now, over here, this makes me go back to one of the basics of marketing, which is the 4 P's of marketing, where it is about product, price, place, promotion. And many of the modern books on marketing talks about the 5th P, which is packaging. And it is over here that staying relevant in today's consumerist society for a human being comes, because we are already aware of the amount of significance that packaging has as far as products are concerned. But similarly, even human beings, the way they package themselves, the way they present themselves, the way they dress up, this becomes extremely important. Now, in today's webinar, the three major areas that I am going to touch upon is ways of making yourself seen and heard in the clutter, branding yourself as a personality, and finally I will be mentioning about how celebrity endorsements are making product brands relevant in the market. Now, when I say ways of making yourself seen and heard in the clutter, If we consider personalities, if we consider human beings, we will find that there are a lot of people who are having a similar qualification, they are into a similar occupation, they are having similar amount of experience. But then what will differentiate a personality A from a personality B? How is that one person out of scores of other persons who are present in the society, how are they going to make a difference over there? So for that, the very next point comes over here, which is branding yourself. Now when I mention this word branding, it is just not about a name. It is just not about, as you know, it is not just about a logo or a symbol. Everyone has get branded. If we have to just stick to the name part, every one of us get branded when we are born. After some time, we get a name for ourselves. But then, that does not differentiate us from scores of other people who are there in the society, who might be in a similar occupation like us. Until and unless we make a differentiation in the way we behave, in the way we act, in the way we work, we will be unable to make our presence felt, seen and heard in the clutter. So branding yourself as a personality is just not about the name. There are certain ingredients involved which have to be carefully looked into. How you shape yourself up, how you present yourself, and these are certain things that I am going to look into in today's presentation. Now, these areas that I have just mentioned have been mentioned in my book, which is Celebrity Branding and Brand Endorsements and Insight. And this particular book is available on lulu.com, and it is also available on the website of Wordsmith University. Now, this particular book has two major sections. The first is on celebrity branding, or personality branding, I shall say. And the second section of the book deals with celebrity endorsements or brand endorsements. Now, many of us have a wrong idea that celebrity branding and celebrity endorsements or brand endorsement is the same thing. Well, celebrity endorsements and brand endorsements are definitely the same thing. But when it comes to celebrity branding, I am talking about just as a product, how can a celebrity or how can a personality brand oneself? Even when we mention the word celebrity, there is a differentiation that exists between celebrities. Celebrities are known to have a different kind of a lifestyle compared to normal human beings. But then not all celebrities are seen and heard in the clutter. There are some celebrities who are seen and heard. There are other celebrities who are just lost in oblivion. Why it is so? That means the other celebrities who are seen and heard, they are doing something extra. They are doing something special in the way they package themselves, in the way they present themselves, because of which they stand recognized. In my book, in the celebrity branding part, I had I've cited various examples from various walks of life. Celebrities like Amitabh Bachchan and Shah Rukh Khan, Saurav Ganguly from the world of cricket, Munna Bhai from the celluloid fictitious character, if I mention. James Bond, again, a fictitious character that was previously to be found in print, and then it came on celluloid, and it just became big. And Harry Potter, again, a particular character that definitely attained cult status, celebrity status, when it was projected on celluloid. And in each case, you find that there have been scores of cricketers, scores of film personalities, scores of celluloid characters which were created, scores of fictitious characters that were created in literature, but these characters, these personalities have stood out, and there was a particular reason why they have stood out. Now, there are various tools and techniques that are involved in this celebrity branding or personality branding part. And that first such tool, technique, or model, whatever you say, it is the brand identity prism that was proposed by Jean Noel Kaeffer in 1986. Over here, as you can find, that there is, as far as a particular brand is concerned, there are certain ingredients which are external to the brand, and there are certain ingredients which are internal to the brand. Now, the those ingredients, those facets which are external to the brand is the physical facet of the brand, the relationship facet, and the reflected consumer. Whereas the facets which are internal to the brand is personality, culture, and consumer mentalization. Now, when we talk about products, it is the marketers who take a lot of time in developing the brand identity prism of a particular product. But when it comes to us, the personalities, many a times it is we who are the marketers of ourselves. And how we project ourselves, the way we look and feel, the way, the kind of relationship we share with the society, the people who are interacting with us, what kind of lifestyle they are leading, what is their state of mind, those people who are interacting with me, what sort of culture and value do I possess as a personality, and definitely my personality facet. And that personality facet has a lot of things. It has something to do with my occupation also. It has also something to do with my experience, and these things do matter. There, as I mentioned when I began this particular webinar today, that there is a strange correlation that exists between products that are available in the market and human beings or personalities. And this brand identity prism is one such particular tool where we find that a similarity exists between products and human beings. Every human being is supposed to have a distinct identity, and it will be this distinct identity that will be promoting a distinct positioning for that particular person in the society. And similar is the case with products also. That means, until and unless you are able to have a very strong identity for yourself, you are not going to be counted. And similarly, until and unless you are having a strong identity for a product, that product is not going to survive in the market. Because understand one thing, there is so much of competition in today's market. Who cares to look at you until and unless you yourself make your presence felt? So this brand identity prism gives you insight of how to develop yourself, how to develop these six varied facets, so that you stand recognized in the society, in this consumerist society. The next important model that I will be looking at and I will like to discuss is a brand asset valuator, which was proposed by Young and Rubicam. And over here you find that when we mention this word brand value, it is also the value of a personality, and that has two major components, brand vitality and brand stature. Now, this brand vitality talks of differentiation and relevance, and you find over here, I mentioned this word differentiation at the beginning of the webinar, personality differentiation. So if you have to stand counted, you have to differentiate yourself. So differentiation is the most important parameter if you want to have or create value for yourself. Why will people like to associate with you? How will you stand relevant in the society? So until and unless you differentiate, so that will be contributing to your brand vitality. The next important thing is how relevant you are, whether people find relevance in interacting with you, whether what you are speaking, what you are doing, does it have any sort of relevance for the society or not, does it have any amount of importance to the society or not. That's a very important thing. The next two parameters are components of brand stature, where the kind of esteem you enjoy. And when I talk of esteem, it is definitely, it has to do with the occupation, it has to do with the popularity in the occupation you are, and it is also about how well people know you. So there is a word in Hindi which is about being a khuli kitab. Now this, when we talk about personality branding, it is very important to understand that how much of a khuli kitab you should be, or how much of an open book you should be. So you need to understand that how much of your personal self you should be opening up to the public and how much of your personal self you should be keeping to yourself. Because if you open up everything to the public, there can be certain controversies arising and people can start making fun of you if they find something, some negativities which are associated with your life. So you need to understand to what degree you should be opening up to the public so that the public has a fair amount of knowledge about you and that contributes to your brand stature. And I have just mentioned some movie personalities from India, and you can well understand that how they have led their lives, what has created to the brand asset value of these people, because they have kept something to themselves and at the same time they have opened a lot of things to the public. People have a fair amount of understanding about their character and that has contributed to their overall brand character. My next popular model will be this 14-point model that talks about celebrity endorsements. Now I believe that when we talk about staying relevant in today's consumerist society comes and we talk about products, celebrity endorsement or brand endorsement is one very, very important tool that contributes to relevance of products in today's consumerist society. And when I talk about the celebrity endorsement, it is not just you bring a celebrity and you ask that person to endorse your brand and your brand will be a success. There is a lot of science involved as far as celebrity endorsement is concerned. You need to understand who will click with which particular product. You need to understand the life cycle of the product, the life cycle of the celebrity, the occupation of the celebrity, the amount of controversy that is associated with the celebrity, the amount of credibility that a particular celebrity enjoys in the society. And because understand one thing, that when we talk of celebrity endorsement, there is something called a rub-off effect of the celebrity on products. Now this rub-off effect has to have a positive effect, not a negative one. No marketer in this world will like to have a negative rub-off effect on their brand until and unless they want to kill the brand. So over here, this particular 14-point model talks about certain characters associated with celebrity endorsement, certain aspects associated with celebrity endorsement that contributes to the success of celebrity endorsements. The first such thing is celebrity credibility. Now Parker Pants, you all will be remembering the advertisement of Amitabh Bachchan endorsing Parker Pants. Well, it's a great ad. The major reason which has contributed to the greatness of this advertisement was the credibility of the celebrity Amitabh Bachchan. And next we look at the celebrity profession and a fit with the advertising idea. We look at various pain balms, Iodex, Saina Nehwal. The profession of the celebrity is such that one is a sports person, one is playing a lot of badminton, and there is a lot of probability that a person gets injured. And when one is getting a minor injury or a moderate injury, one will be looking for rubbing a balm, and which is Iodex. So the celebrity profession over here, the celebrity that I am considering for my Iodex, is gelling well with the overall idea of the product. And it is also fitting with the overall advertising idea. That is, there is a pain balm that is going to give you relief from pains. The celebrity physical attractiveness does make a lot of importance. It has a lot of significance, especially for cosmetic brands or for various other products, because this now if I go back to that particular identity prism thing, you will be remembering that I mentioned about physical facet. So this physical facet has a lot of importance, and this has again a positive rub-off effect on the products being endorsed. Whether the celebrity is a brand user, it makes a lot of sense. Whether the celebrity is a brand user. Because until and unless a celebrity is using the brand, the consumers of that particular brand will have a doubt that whether this brand is right for me or not. You will be remembering sometime back, Sonali Bendre, one of Bollywood actresses, was endorsing some Nirma soap. Now Nirma, the brand we know, it is for the middle class people. Sonali Bendre is no middle class person. And then immediately when you see this kind of an ad, you don't relate to that particular ad. Nirma soap was never relevant to the consumerist society. Nirma soap, I suppose, it has died a natural death by now. So you understand that how these things are related to the overall topic that I am discussing today. The next, the celebrity values, the culture of the celebrity, the background of the celebrity does count and does have a positive rub-off effect. Multiple endorsements, yes. In the Indian context, many a times this has a negative effect. But overall, what has been found through research, because my area of PhD has been in the area of celebrity endorsements. And what I have found over there through my empirical study was that multiple endorsements as such do not have much of a negative value on brands till such time that there is a proper gel, a proper fit that exists between the celebrity and the brand. The moment that thing is not existing, it is not going to work. So you might be finding a Sachin Tendulkar endorsing an energy drink, a Sachin Tendulkar endorsing an insurance policy, Sachin Tendulkar endorsing consumer durable, Sachin Tendulkar endorsing FMCG. But again, this particular thing reminds me that Sachin Tendulkar was at one point of time endorsing a brand called Ujala. And I have a lot of doubts that to what extent the sale of Ujala had gone up because of Sachin Tendulkar endorsing it. Probably over there, this gel between the celebrity and the brand did not work because of which multiple endorsements did not work over there. The celebrity controversy risk is always there because, as I mentioned, is word open book. Now, there are various celebrities who keep it everything in the open and lot of controversies crop up. And when you have a controversial celebrity on board to endorse a particular brand, the rub-off effect has it that your brand also becomes controversial. And you need to have serious concerns as a marketer of how to erase this controversy. So while you are going for selecting celebrities to make your brand, to keep your brand relevant in today's consumerist society, you have to look at it whether your celebrity is a controversial one or is a non-controversial one. There is definitely a huge cost of acquiring a celebrity, and so you will have to look at the celebrity product match. And many a times in the Indian context, since we have so much of so many cultures, so many dialects existing, regional appeal of celebrities do matter a lot. If you remember the recent advertisements of Manappuram Gold Loan, over there you will be remembering that there was Akshay Kumar also, there was Mithun Chakravarti also, and there was other endorsers also. Akshay Kumar was mainly meant for endorsing the brand at a national level, whereas it was Mithun Chakravarti who was endorsing this brand at a regional level in the eastern part of the country. The reason is the appeal of the celebrity and reaching out to the masses. And that is the reason why often marketers tend to go for multiple celebrities at a particular point of time to cater to different sections of the public who are a significant section, so that the particular brand stays relevant everywhere. The gelling between the celebrity and the product I have already mentioned, a gel between celebrity and target audience is extremely, extremely important. Because I have a particular product, and I have a particular celebrity for the product, and I have a particular target audience for the product. If there is no confluence which is happening between these three areas, there is no gelling which is happening, then my product is not going to stay relevant. And ultimately, it is about celebrity popularity. Definitely, we can understand that a celebrity has to be popular. Otherwise, there is no use going for celebrity endorsement. So you will have to see that you are having a popular celebrity on board to endorse your brand. Well, that brings me to the end of this particular show this particular webinar. Any questions? I would like some questions from your end.
I'm going to ask you questions using the chat box, or if you want, you can just chat in the chat box and we shall unmute you. Thank you. I don't see any question. In that case, let me thank you first for attending the webinar for the time. Please note this webinar will be recorded. We shall be sending you shortly your talk presentation and the PPT. Secondly, we have also scheduled a series of webinars in the month of May, including a panel discussion. We are also having a lecture on business development, which will be shortly announced. We have also got the book on which Professor Roy Crandly gave his presentation displayed with the university and the Lulu. So you can buy from either from the university or from Lulu. Thank you. And we also request you to stay tuned for further events at Western University. And last but not least, at Western University, we have nowadays calling it the People's Business School. And we always invite all our associates, friends, and indeed students. To teach and learn. If you are interested in a teacher, the platform is free. You can just register, submit a course you want to teach, either make it free or pay one, and we shall promote, spread our network. Provide a promotion platform just like you see, and we still continue. All our webinars are recorded and displayed either the free or standalone video on the Western University site, and I hope. Western University is actually funded, controlled, and subsidized by Western Communication, which is the modern action transition agency. And on behalf of Western University, Western Communication, or NHAT team, I thank Professor Roy for his time, for his preparation, and his final busy schedule coming here and presenting. You can directly contact him as well. I hope he has given his contact. We should be providing his contact as well. And in case you are interested for a development session, it is then also quite possible, but you should anyway. So thank you, Professor Roy. If you have any funding three, please go ahead. And thank you once again for your time on the busy Monday.
Thank you, Mr. Bhattacharya. Any questions?